Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. As you may remember, my name is Sana, and today we are going to talk about someone who helped landing on the moon. She is Margaret Hamilton. Margaret Hamilton is really talented. But Margaret Hamilton, since she was a kid, she loved math. But back then, this is not the rule, but this is how most people did it. Margaret Hamilton, she was the mom, so she would have to take care of her kid, and her dad would go, her husband would go to work. And then Margaret Hamilton, soon she got interested in something. It was really exciting. NASA's scientists, they were working hard on something, flying people to the moon. Margaret Hamilton, she really convinced one of NASA's leaders to let her try. So Margaret Hamilton, she thought of everything that could go wrong. What if it lost its power? What if an astronaut did a mistake? Where she got, if an astronaut did a mistake, is she wanted to show her kid around her office. And then her kid, she did something. She pressed a button for a mistake and made something to stop working. And then Margaret thought, oh, what if an astronaut makes a mistake? And then but other people said, no, astronauts are trained really well. They never make mistakes in the landing when they go to rocket ships. But do they really not make mistakes ever? Probably not. But first, Margaret had to, many people are working there, and they can't just go land on the moon. There are stuff like Apollo's, where they need to do lots of stuff with the moon. So first, Apollo 8 went and it just circled around the moon, Apollo 11 was when they're really gonna land on the moon. So, and then when they landed on the moon, Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin, one of them did a mistake. He pressed something wrong. And then the computer, he was handling so much things, and it had too much things, and it couldn't do the important thing, landing on the moon. But had Margaret Hamilton prepared for it? She had. She had put her code into the computer, so they landed safely onto the moon. Margaret Hamilton, she also became a teacher, and I'm going to become that when I grow up, I think. Also, after she became a teacher, she did something called software, and she called herself a software engineer. One of them, when he did a step on the moon, he said, "One small step for a man, one huge leap for mankind." It's what he said when he landed on the moon. We all know Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin, but we don't know a hero. She's Margaret Hamilton. She helped landing on the moon. She helped because, remember, they did a mistake, but they landed safely because of her.
Her example speaks of the American spirit of discovery that exists in every little girl and little boy who know that somehow to look beyond the heavens is to look deep within ourselves.
Being fearless, even when the experts say no, it doesn't make sense. They didn't believe it. Nobody did. It was something that we were dreaming of happening, but it became real.
Also, if you and me become an astronaut when you grow up, sometimes when you go to the moon, you can find the American flag that has been put almost like in the first rocket ship landing. With Buzz Aldrin and Neil Armstrong, they put the American flag there. So if you and I become an astronaut, we can go to the moon and we can even see it. I hope you enjoyed this video. I thought you were wondering about the sound one. We'll do it next time. Go and check out my other videos too. Bye. Guess what? So when I was a little kid, I even went to the NASA museum and I touched a rock. It was a moon rock. I don't remember how it felt, but I'm sure that it didn't feel like a normal one.